Hello everybody, my name is Leo and in this video we share a demo review of the new X MG30. First of all, we will hear the unit in action with a double demo song, then we will describe the main characteristics of the unit, then we will hear more sounds in a dedicated section of this video, and finally, as usually, I will give you my 2 cents. So I hope you enjoy, and please don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell, as it would really help me to make more videos like this. Let's start with the demo song. First of all, the form factor. The dimensions are 313 by 166 by 54 millimeters, and it weighs 1.5 kilos. Therefore, it is very similar to an Ampero, bigger and weightier than an Ampero 1, and smaller and lighter than a Moore G250. It has 3 foot switches, so less than the G250 and the Ampero, and in line with the Ampero 1. You have included in the package the NMP2, that are 2 additional foot switches, with which you can turn on and off specific effects. So it's like having a stomp mode. It has a pretty nice 4 inches color screen that is as big as the one of the Ampero and bigger than the one of the G250, which is a 2.5 inches screen, and it is not touch sensitive. The layout of the unit is pretty clear, and I like the 2 columns of signal block switcher that are similar to the Moore ones, and that I found pretty handy to quickly work on a specific effect. In fact, you can switch on and off effects just pressing the relative button, or you can edit the effect just pressing longer the same button. Pretty handy. Its construction quality is far better than the one of the new XMG300 that was plasticky and not very solid. The MG30 is much more robust and sturdy in comparison with the MG300, even because it is not made out of plastic. It offers 25 guitar amps, 3 bass amplifiers, 2 acoustic guitar amps, 8 guitar speaker cabinets and 8 bass guitar cabinets, 8 microphones each with 3 positions and 3 acoustic guitar IRs, and you can load your own IRs. So it's in line with the philosophy of the MG300, not offering a huge amount of amp simulations as other brands do. And furthermore, what I like a lot, for instance, is that the computer app interface really recalls the real amp, as in this example it recalls the front end of the JCM800. As regards effects, I was pleasingly surprised by the quality of the MG300 effects, and the MG30 is also better here, as there is also the possibility to have parallel chorus delay and reverse, something pretty unique in this price range and that other modelers does not offer. Furthermore, we have 11 effect blocks that are independent and movable. As I was saying, in this price range, the kind of flexibility in the effect chain you have is a unicum and not something other modeler builders are offering. It shares with the MG300 the same high quality converters at 32 bits and 48 kHz with 110 dB of dynamic range, which is a pretty good value that fits between the GE250 with 100 dB and the Ampero with 120 dB of dynamic range. And obviously it can also serve as an audio interface for your computer with 2 USB channels. It has 2 DSP chips offering double the power of the MG300. Is it gonna sound much better than the MG300? Well, subscribe and hit the bell not to miss my future videos where we will compare the MG30 versus the MG300. It offers a 30-second stereo looper with a synchronized drum machine like the MG300. Let's now have a look at the I/O. It has obviously a guitar input, an aux in, an headphone out, a mono effect loop, a left and right unbalanced output, an expression pedal input, and a USB-C port. So here the goods are the USB-C port. Thank you, New X, I love USB-C port that are much better than the Type-B, as for instance they are reversible. The send and return effect loop that basically allows us to use the MG30 with the 4 cable method with our amp, if you want. The only cons I would mention here are the missing XLR outputs that, for instance, are available in the GE250 or the Ampero, and the fact that the FL loop is mono and therefore you cannot connect the stereo effects. So these are the main characteristics of this unit. Let's now share some more sounds. Here we are in the more sound section of this video. Let's gonna check out some sound. This is the PC application. I like the layout because you have the real amp in front of you with the real knobs, and on the left you have all the presets. As you may notice, there are presets from some great guitar players. For instance, there are the Pete Tornes presets, and ta-dan, there are also mine 9A, B and C. So it's really an honor for me to be together with these great players. Now, these are the presets basically I've used in the demo songs for the bass, for the clean guitar, for the crunch guitar and for the solo guitar. I've used this crunch sound in the first demo song, and as you may notice, this preset is of a Marshall JCM800 that I really like. This was actually the riff at the beginning of the song. I like this sound. It is pretty responsive, it cleans up nicely. The more you push, the more it breaks up, as the real arm. Very nice. If you want some more gain, you can add the tube screamer. Then you have obviously the reverb section, delay and modulation. For instance, the delay. I like ping pong delay in stereo. Okay, let's hear the reverb. Lovely. Let's add some modulation. So here I have a univibe. Let's move it in front of the amp as a real univibe. So actually the JCM 800 model is the one that I like the most. I can't stop playing. But now let's check out the clean. Is made around the Deluxe Reverb and is the one you have heard at the beginning of the second demo song. And here I'm using a Ribbon mic, a Royer 122, that provides you with a more mellow tone. Of course you can change it, you just have to press the right button of the mouse and this list shows up. For this clean tone I prefer the Royer. Let's remove the delay and the modulation to better hear the amp. Pretty nice sounding. And for the solo, I use a Soldano model. Let's remove the delay so we can better hear the amp. So I use a pretty gainy tone, you can reduce a little bit the gain. I use a pretty mellow tone in my song, but obviously you can change it. The cab is a vintage 30 and the mic is an SM57. You can also change the position of the mic simply dragging it and you have three positions: center, middle, or the left. Okay, these were my presets. Obviously you have a lot more presets. Let's try another amp, for instance, a Friedman. Now let's return to the clean amp just to try to better listen to some effects. Just reverb. Let's add some chorus. I like this gentle chorus that is not too much intrusive. Of course, you have also other type of choruses. For instance, here you have a stereo chorus. But I like the C2. And here you have the possibility to have effect in series or in parallel. Now they are in series. As you may notice, this double line here is not highlighted, so they are in series. And if I press here, I can put it in parallel. So now the chorus and the delay are in parallel. And now chorus, delay and reverb, all three in parallel. Obviously we have to switch on the delay. Okay, just to hear the difference, let's put again them in series. Okay, you can decide obviously which one is better for you. Final considerations here, and please notice that these are gonna be my personal opinion and you may not agree with me, and this is totally fine. Let me just say that I received this unit from NewX without paying, so my opinion could be biased. Nevertheless, I will try to be as much objective as I can. Let's share the pros and cons in my opinion. The pros. Well, first of all, the effect signal chain. 11 swappable blocks with the possibility to have parallel delays, reverbs and choruses are pretty rare in this price range. Then another pro is the construction quality, as this unit is pretty sturdy. Then I would mention the NMP2, I mean the two extra foot switches included in the box that basically allows us to have 5 foot switches and to operate in stomp mode. Last but not least, the sound. Well, you can judge by yourself, and I think that the sounds in the demo song are pretty realistic. As regards the cons, I would mention the missing balance output. It would have been a pretty cool option to have 2 USB channels in order to record the effects into tracks and the amp in another track, to be able to decide the amount of effects in post while mixing. And basically nothing else comes to my mind, also considering the price of the unit. So all in all, I think that here we have a pretty high value for money. With $300, it's pretty difficult to get something better. And the only thing I would miss is some sort of profiling procedure. But you know, we cannot have everything. But what's your opinion? What are the most important features of this unit for you? How do you think it sounds? And what about the value for money? To which other AMP modeling pedalboard would you like me to compare the MG30? Please let me know in the comment below. We have now reached the end of this video. I hope you enjoyed, and if you did, please subscribe to my channel, hit the notification bell and leave a thumbs up. It would be of great help. If you're interested in my IR, so in my camper profiles, you can check out the link in the card above or description below, where there is also a link to a playlist of songs of mine. Thank you for watching, see you in the next video. Bye bye.